Hello everyone. In this video, we are learning about the benefits of mushroom cultivation. Mushrooms are not plants, and they require different conditions for optimal growth. Plants develop their own food through photosynthesis. It is a process that converts atmospheric carbon dioxide into carbohydrates, especially cellulose. While sunlight provides an energy source for plants, mushrooms derive all of their energy and growth materials from their growth medium through biochemical decomposition processes. This does not mean that light is an irrelevant requirement, since some fungi use light as a signal for fruiting. However, all the materials for growth must already be present in the growth medium. Mushrooms grow well at relative humidity levels of around 95 to 100%. And substrate moisture levels of 50 to 75%. Instead of seeds, mushrooms reproduce through spores. Spores can be contaminated with airborne microorganisms, which will interfere with mushroom growth and prevent a healthy crop. Mycelium, or actively growing mushroom culture, is placed on a substrate, usually sterilized grains, such as rye or millet, and induced to grow into those grains. This is called inoculation. Inoculated grains, or plugs, are referred to as spawn. Spores are another inoculation option, but are less developed than established mycelium. Since they are also contaminated easily, they are only manipulated in laboratory conditions with a laminar flow cabinet. Cultivated mushrooms have now become popular all over the world. There are over 200 genera of macro fungi which contain species of use to people. 12 species are commonly grown for food or medicinal purposes across tropical and temperate zones. Commercial markets are dominated by Agaricus bisporus, Lentinula edoda, and Pleurotus species, which represent 3/4 of mushrooms cultivated globally. In this video, mainly we are discuss about the socioeconomic benefit, health benefit, ecological benefit, and economic benefits of mushroom cultivation. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, do subscribe now. Also, you can join the upcoming free webinar on gardening and mushroom cultivation, the link is in the description. Number 1, socioeconomic benefit of mushroom cultivation. The people can get themselves trained on mushroom cultivation or mushroom seed or spawn production to earn for their livelihood. It is a very profitable entrepreneurship. One can get a minimum 40% profit out of mushroom cultivation. It can provide self-employment opportunity to a large number of unemployed youth, farmers, and especially women. Women in Terai region of India are mostly confined to indoor activities. They can perform it in their house to generate additional income and improve their socioeconomic conditions. Number 2, health benefit. Mushrooms are good source of vitamin B, C, and D, including niacin, riboflavin, thiamine, and folate, and various minerals like potassium, phosphorus, calcium, magnesium, iron, and copper. They provide carbohydrates, but are low in fat and fiber and contain no starch. Furthermore, edible mushrooms are an excellent source of high-quality protein, reportedly between 19% to 35%, and white button mushrooms contain more protein than kidney beans. In addition to all the essential amino acids, some mushrooms have medicinal benefits of certain polysaccharides, which are known to boost the immune system. Medicinal fungi have routinely been used in traditional Chinese medicine. Today, an estimated 6% of edible mushrooms are known to have medicinal properties and can be found in health tonics, tinctures, teas, soups, and herbal formulas. Lentinula edoda, shiitake, and Volvariella volvacea, paddy straw mushroom, are edible fungi with medicinal properties. They are widely diffused and cultivated. The medicinal properties of mushrooms depend on several bioactive compounds, and their bioactivity depends on how mushrooms are prepared and eaten. Shiitake are said to have antitumor and antiviral properties and remove serum cholesterol from the bloodstream. Other species, such as pleurotus, oyster, flemulina, enoki, termella, ener, and griffula, mitake, all have varying degrees of immune system boosting, lipid lowering, anti-tumor, microbial, and viral properties, blood pressure regulating, and other therapeutic effects. Mushrooms represent a vast source of, yet undiscovered, potent pharmaceutical products, and their biochemistry would merit further investigation. Number 3, ecological benefits. Commonly used line, growing mushrooms is equal to creating fertile soils. Saprophytic and parasitic fungi help to create the organic components of topsoil in alliance with large numbers of bacteria, insects, and other organisms. An orchestra of primary, secondary, and tertiary saprophytic fungi render wood into biodynamic soil components. These soils benefit plants that in turn have photosynthesis to manufacture their own foods. Fungi can selectively raise or lower soil pH, increasing the usability of existing soils without the need for additional adjustment prior to use. For example, a comparison of nutritive content between commercial soil and composted shiitake mushroom cultivation waste is taken out. You can see the difference. Number 4, economic benefits. Mushroom cultivation activities can play an important role in supporting the local economy by contributing to subsistence food security, nutrition, and medicine, generating additional employment and income through local, regional, and national trade, and offering opportunities for processing enterprises such as pickling and drying. Mushrooms constitute one of the most promising resources for promoting rapid socioeconomic development. Cultivation of mushroom is a source of national income as well as a means of poverty alleviation. The production of mushroom creates a large number of direct and indirect employment opportunities in cultivation as well as in marketing activities as a labor-intensive management and offering opportunities for processing enterprises. Mushroom farming needs low capital, low technical knowledge, and even in an indoor setting it is possible to cultivate mushroom in a small scale, and one can easily get high return with low investment. Women can cultivate mushroom in their homes, like rearing poultry, with a little capital. Therefore, mushroom cultivation not only empower rural women, but also alleviate poverty from the grassroots level. I hope you liked the video. We shall keep posting about various crops and plants in the horticulture segment along with the mushroom video. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, do subscribe now.